Hello, I'm Dr. Giuseppe Giordano, a PhD student of Mathematics at University of Salerno, and today I present a short review of some mathematical methods to detect fake news. This work is written by me, Dr. Serena Mottola, and Professor Beatrice Patete. Let's start by giving a definition of fake news. Fake news is a term used to indicate a set of articles written, invented, misleading, or distorted information. In particular, fake news represent the contrarian of news that is created by ignoring completely editorial rules and process adopted in the media to ensure complaints. The most common mistake that is made today in a society where digital is increasingly integrated with our lifestyle is to think that the larger is think to that that access to a large amount of data is automatically synonymous of freedom and democracy. The problem of fake news is already existed, but it has reached even alarming level in the last decade, the last decade, resulting from the birth of the social media. In fact, it's low cost, easy access with people to seek out and consume news from social media. Fake news broad diffusion is related to the feeling that they stimulate in the user, and users are allow themselves to be bullied into content that simply confirm their thought and feeling, and even if it's not the truth. And these are some examples of fake news. In fact, fake news covers all topics such as medicine, science, politics, sports, and so on. The first example regards the relationship between vaccines and autism. In fact, in the 1998, Dr. Wakefield and his colleagues published an article that confirmed this relationship. Despite several studies have shown that this relationship doesn't exist, there are some parents that who are afraid of vaccinating their children. Another example regards the American election in 2017, and during the last 3 months of of American election, the fake news showed an evident overtaking. Compared to real news, as we see in this point. During an emergent period, such as the period of COVID-19, the fake news makes infants markedly. There are some examples of fake news produced in this period. And to contrast the spread of fake news, coronavirus factor aliens was created. This figure shows the the waves of access produced in this period, and these graphs helps Alliance to identify successive ways of misinformation. The principal problem is to automate the detection of fake news. The first method that we would analyze is based on the classification. Classification, in particular, is a statistic technique that uses an algorithm to detect a subpopulation with certain characteristics in a larger set. There are various types of classifier, and in particular, we used the classifier based on the well-known Bayes theorem, which asserts that the probability of H given E is equal to the product of the probability of E given H and probability of H divided by the probability of E. The principle that regulates the type of classifier is very simple and is the following. The individual belongs to a class of interest with a given probability, and this probability are calculated assuming that the presence or absence of a particular characteristic in a given class of interest is not correlated by the presence of other characteristics. The method that we are presenting was developed by Greinich et al. In 2017. And the idea is more simple, and is the following. Fake news articles often use the same set of words, while the true article have a different set of words. This formula represents the probability that a news article is fake, and it is given by the ratio between P1 and the sum of P1 and P2, where P1 is the product of the conditional probability that a given article is fake given that it contains a specific word WVI. N represents the number of words present in the articles. P2 is the same of P1, but we used the complementary probabilities. The dataset used to test the method is collected by BuzzFeed. An American Society of Media, and during the period analyzed, the team of journalists collected information about Facebook posts of three large pages of right and left political orientation, as well as three large mainstream pages. And the team of journalists analyzed 2,282 Facebook posts and observed that the right political orientation pages are more prone to spread false information. Correlated respect to the left political orientation page, but mainstream page doesn't publish false information, but a small post, including unverified information. To test the classifier, the dataset was mixed and divided into three subsets: training dataset, validation dataset, and test dataset. And in particular, training dataset was used to train the naive Bayes classifiers. Validation dataset was used to tune some global parameter of the classifier, and the test dataset was used to get an estimation of how well the classifier performs on new data. And if the word are unknown, the classifier can't classify the user, the given particle. To test the model, let's give the definition of precision, and it is given by the ratio between the number of new articles correctly classified as fake and the number of news articles incorrectly classified as fakes, and the number of news articles correctly classified as fake. The precision for giving classifier is 0.71, and it means that 71% of fake news are correctly classified as fake. Another model that we analyzed is based on the use of artificial neural network, ANN. And a single neuron receives a vector input, multiplied scalarly by a vector of weight. After a single neuron applied an activation function to the weighted sum, and the output y is given. But the single artificial neuron represents the simplest. Artificial neural network, but it was correlated by other network to create more complex artificial neural network. The neuron is connected in a layer in which the output of the determined level is the input of the next level. In particular, the most commonly used layer are fully connected layer, which all neurons are connected with all our neurons, as we see. Despite during the time different types of neural network are created, it is possible to represent two topologies, feed-forward network and recurrent neural network. Feed-forward network has an input layer, an output layer, and various number of hidden layers, and in the hidden layer, the processing takes place. Comparing to the presence to the previous one, recurrent neural network FNN has a connection, and that has connection, and the presence of this connection allows the network to consider the time context in which inputs are presented. The model that we want to introduce is developed by Natalie Ronchak et al. In 2017, and that use artificial neural network and the similar value decomposition of a matrix. The idea of this method is the following. There are three common features to fake news articles, and they are the text of an article, the response that it receives, and the source. The resource. Each one of the three characteristics has ambiguous that make difficult the detection of fake news based on one of them. CSI method uses all three features. And it is composed of three components: capture, score, and integrate. And we see in detail. Now we see in detail. Capture uses a recurrent neural network to establish the number of users that engage with an article EJ, and the engagement have been spaced over time. The input of the recurrent neural network is the vector, where eta and delta t, so the first two variables. Capture the temporal partner or the temporal partner of engagement an article receives. In particular, eta is the number of engagement and delta t is the time between engagement. XU represent the source of the article, and it is a global parameter and not specific for a given article. XTAU is a vector which includes the text feature of an engagement with an article with an article received. Next, the binary incident matrix X is constructed, and it is equal to 1 if the user UI has interacted with the article AJ, and it is equal to 0 otherwise. X is constructed to determine the number of articles that engage with a user. And next, the singular value, the composition SVD of, ma- of H, of AX, is applied to extract a lower dimensional representation for each user UI. The output of a component is the vector VG, and this vector serves a low-dimensional representation of the temporal partner of engagement a given article AJ received. The second component score calculates a suspicious score for each user UI. And in particular given a set of user features, first a fully connected layer is used to extract vector representation of each user in this way, where WWU is the weight matrix and BU is the vector of BS. The score SI for user UI is calculated in this way. It's calculated this way. And sigma represents the sigmoid function, and WVS is a weight vector, and BS is the BS vector. The last component integrate combines the information of the previous component score and capture to produce a label LTJ for each article AJ. To integrate the two modules, the MJ mask is applied to the vector S, where S is the vector of all SI. That contain all component for each user. This mask select only the inference S con E that engaged with the article AG. That represent the user UI that engage with an article AJ. Sigma represent the sigmoid function, and WB represent the weight vector, and BC is the BS. To test the classify two datasets are used, and in particular it is given by Twitter and Weibo, and this table represents some detail of the dataset. The second table contains the result in terms of accuracy and F score for each dataset. We see that CSI is a very performing method compared to other methods present in the literature. In particular, CI and CIT are a variant of the CSI method. The first uses only text feature, and the second uses both the text and the temporal feature of the articles. To conclude, nowadays some algorithms have been implemented in order to try to automate the detection of fake news, and mathematics has played and still plays an important role in the detection of fake news. Future works will include new mathematical modeling to try to stop the fake news phenomenon diffusa. And also we would like to determine new numerical measures to anticipate the spread of fake news based on ordinary differential equations, which are used good for evolutionary problem. These are some references that we used to the review, and thanks for your attention.